All right, and here's our official welcome to the New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra Spring 2023 Concerts. It's a little dark in the house, but I'm pretty sure this is the most people we've played for, ever. So thank you everyone for coming. We really appreciate it. This group back here will be introduced more formally over the course of the evening. Right now, we're just going to start with a chamber piece, even though there's most of us are on stage already. We're going to start with about a 20-person subset of the orchestra. And this is a piece from a little game called The Legend of Zelda. Just a little game, you know. Any Wind Waker fans in the house? I just hear the Wind Waker fans. That's a favorite, I think. So this is a very interesting take of Wind Waker, arranged first-time arranger, Jackie, for the group. And it weaves a lot of like very old Baroque elements into the music. You'll hear a lot of counterpoint. You'll hear the harpsichord, actually, which is a very old instrument from about the 1500s or so, and this piece is just, it's great. We've been working very hard on this piece. Before we get started with this beautiful Legend of Zelda piece, I want to give a quick shout out to Nick and Fusion Core for providing our gong for tonight. So give it up for the Fusion Core. They're playing a lot this summer, awesome marching band music. If you wanna come and see them, they're really great. I know they're playing July in Clifton. So yes, thank you again to them for providing the gong for us. All right, let's get some music started. How about that?
Thank you.
Again, everyone. Just gonna one more reminder about the flash photography. Just make sure your flashes are off on your cameras. All right. And yes, so here is all of the, not the whole New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra yet, because that also involves the choir who they'll come out for the next piece, but this is the New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra instrumentalists. So just introducing this group here. So yeah, we are a community-based orchestra. We rehearse here in North Jersey. We meet every Sunday. We have been performing video game music since about 2016 or so, a little bit before, maybe 2014. And yeah, this is the group that you see today. We started out as a very small group of about 10 people, and now we're pushing 60, I think. So that's really exciting. All right, so this next piece comes from a little world-building game of sorts. I think probably one of the first of its kind. It's called SimCity. So if you don't know SimCity, you're gonna really like the music. The music is incredible. In this game, you are the mayor of a town, and you start by building up a small little village, and over time, the village grows and grows into a town, and then into a small city, you know, a bigger city, so on and so forth, until you have this sprawling megalopolis, you know, and then you can almost just imagine just like being in a place like New York City, where there's so much going on, so much hustle and bustle, and everything's just speeding by you, and that's the sounds of Megalopolis. It's the fastest part of this tune. But eventually, things kind of slow down, and you hear where that city started so many decades, so many centuries ago. You'll hear that original village team. Without further ado, this is Megalopolis from SimCity.
Thank you.
right. Now I'd like to introduce someone else to take the podium. This is Kyle Mesh. He is our assistant director, assistant music director and conductor. So I'm going to introduce him, and yeah, we're going to get on to our next piece.
Right. Thank you all so much for coming out today. It really does mean a lot to us that you're all here to celebrate our love for video game music here today. So for this next piece that we're about to play for you, I should ask the audience, how many of you had an N64 or still have an N64? Quite a number of you then. So does the game Banjo-Kazooie ring a bell? It does over there, I see. So this next medley of tunes is from Banjo-Kazooie and also Banjo-Tooie as well. I don't think it needs a lot of introduction if you grew up with an N64, but you'll hear a lot of different tracks from, say, a desert world, an ice world, an underwater world as well. You might also hear the Banjo-Kazooie theme song a couple of different ways, so definitely be on the listen for that. In addition, we can't play a Banjo-Kazooie medley without a banjo and some kazooies, so let's bring out our kazoo players with our lovely choir. And playing the banjo, it is none other than our director herself. Please join me in welcoming our one and only Elisa Menes. And before we get started on this piece, I will say just one quick thing about why I in particular am very excited to be playing in this medley here with NJGSO today. So I was one of those unfortunate souls that did not have an N64 growing up. I was a PlayStation kid back in the day. So naturally, I had to fill in a lot of those gaps as I was growing older. But I just want to say a huge shout out to Rob, Michael, and Zach for getting me into Banjo-Kazooie and Banjo-Tooie as well. Even though with Banjo-Tooie, I had played that, let's say, early 2020, and then the rest of it wasn't until a couple or a few years later. But you might know the reason for that, because obviously there was a thing called COVID where there was a very long gap in between the start of Banjo-Tooie and the end of that. Trying to figure out the controls again was very, very fun, I'll tell you that much. So without further ado, please sit back, relax, and enjoy this medley of tunes from Banjo-Kazooie. Thank you. Long live the N64. If you haven't had the chance to look at the coffees we are selling, one of them is Bear and Brew, named after Banjo-Kazooie. There's a bunch of others named after some of the pieces that we are playing for you tonight. So check it out if you haven't already. So for this next piece that we are going to perform for you tonight, it is an all-choir piece, and I am going to let our assistant choral director introduce that a little more. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming Pamela Farmer.
Welcome again. Thank you so much for being here with us. Several months ago, Alisa, our director, pitched the idea of us doing an a cappella piece with the choir. So I said, well, I've been working on a little something. What if we do this? She said, sure. And I said, you know, it would also be really nice if we could have a few more people, because there's only 10 of us in the choir. It'd be really neat if we had at least a few more. We have 18 altogether. Thank you so much, choir. Once they get ready, they'll be on. Our instrumentalists, some of our instrumentalists are multi-talented people. I myself also play flute. Several of our instrumentalists also play multiple instruments and also sing, and some of them were gracious enough to join us for this piece, which is The Promised Land from Advent Children, which is the movie that follows Final Fantasy VII, the original, not the remake. They'll maybe get to it in the remake, we can hope. This piece is done in a liturgical style, so think your Latin ecclesiastical music, not quite as far back as Gregorian chant, but entirely choir. Sometimes you don't save the world. Or sometimes you do, but not entirely. And so the world has to save itself. And that's what happens at the end of Final Fantasy VII. The planet has to save itself and sends forth the life stream to save the planet from the meteor spell that Sephiroth called down. And it's mad about it. And it's real mad about it. We had our 2020 plague. The people of Midgar have their own plague called geostigma. It affects everyone from kids to adults, including the hero himself, Cloud. And this piece is asking why. Why are we being punished? Except we know why. We hurt the planet, and it's our karma is getting paid back for that. So it's very resigned, and honestly, a very good demonstration of how skilled Nobuo Uematsu is as a composer. So I see our choir is ready. Without further ado, I am very proud to present The Promised Land.
right. This is our last piece before intermission, actually. So let me bring the choir back on stage. That amazing choir. All right, this is the full New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra, their choir and everyone. So round of applause for this amazing group. You may have noticed, I talked about it before, the giant gong sitting on stage. So the reason why we have this gong, and thanks again to Fusion Core for lending it to us for today, the reason why we have this gong is because this next piece is called Gong. And in a piece called Gong, you're not gonna hear triangle, you're gonna hear a gong. So we need a gong. There it is. And you'll hear from that gong in just a moment. So, this next game, I'd just like to say, you know what, we like to play all sorts of game music. We like to play super well-known stuff like Mario and Zelda. Then we like to play some deeper cuts like SimCity. Now, this one is a game that I'm not sure if many people have played this one, at least not in the US. In Japan, though, this game is wildly popular. And I'm going to try to get the title of the game correct. It's very long. Third Super Robot Wars Alpha. Hey, I did it. It only took a season, and I did it. So this whole series, actually, let me ask you, any Gundam fans out there? All right. Evangelion fans? Oh, Evangelion got a great shout out. Mazinger Z? Sakura Tyson? All right, and you can see all of that and more in Third Super Robot Wars Alpha for the PlayStation 2. So this game is pretty much like Japan's equivalent of Super Smash Brothers, another title you may have heard of. It has over 130, take that Smash, pilots to play as. And about the music you're going to hear, any fans of anime music? All right. So if you don't know what anime music sounds like, brace yourselves, you're going to know. This is Gong. Thank you. How about that gong? When they sing Gongo Narase, it means sound the gong, and we sure did. All right, before we take our break, I actually want to introduce a very important person. You heard the wonderful choir singing, and Gordon has been our choir director since 2016, I think. And I think it's time to give him a shout out at our concert. Gordon works tirelessly to work with this choir, and he does amazing work with them, and he doesn't get enough credit. And Gordon, you're amazing. Thank you for everything you do. All right, so before, again, we take our break, we have our bake sale table outside. I think there's stuff left out there, but there's a lot of you. If there's nothing left, that's great, because there's a lot of you, and that's awesome. We also have our raffle, so please be sure to enter our raffle. We're going to draw some raffle winners before our last piece tonight. So there's a lot of great prizes. I hear there is a pound of, what's that? Merch table too, yes. We have our merch table as well. And for a raffle, there's a pound of like home roasted coffee, really nice stuff. Enter the raffle for that. There's also a code for a little game that just came out a couple weeks ago. What's that game? Tears of the Kingdom. So you may be going home with a digital copy of Tears of the Kingdom if you enter our raffle. So yes, and then please visit our merch table as well. We have stickers, we have magnets, and soon we'll be selling t-shirts. Not tonight, unfortunately, but very soon our Redbubble store will be up for that. So yeah, I'll see you all in about 25 minutes or so. All right, let's get started with the second half of our concert. Is everyone having fun so far? All right. Oh yeah, that's what I like to hear. Yeah, we have a couple more really exciting songs for everyone, and we're gonna just kick it off with the excitement to open up our second half. So I'm expecting an uproar for this one. Any Pokemon fans in the house? All right, give a shout out for your favorite generation. I'm gonna call them off. Red and blue. Gold and silver. Ooh, okay. Ruby and sapphire. All right. Diamond and pearl. Black and white. I remember. X and Y. Okay, I like that one. All right, so this brings us to Sun and Moon. All right, okay, so more shout outs for Diamond and Pearl, and there's other generations too, but you know, we're playing from Sun and Moon. So yeah, more shout outs for Diamond and Pearl, but this piece is really exciting from Pokémon Sun and Moon. It is actually arranged by one of the members of the Baltimore Gamer Symphony Orchestra. So we're not the only Gamer Symphony Orchestra in the country. There are quite a few, and if I can give them all a shout out, hopefully I remember them all. We have the Baltimore Gamer Symphony Orchestra, the Washington Metro Gamer Symphony Orchestra, the University of Maryland Gamer Symphony Orchestra, the Ithaca Gamer Symphony Orchestra, Norwalk Gamer Symphony Orchestra, Reno Gamer Symphony Orchestra, and many, many other, hope I'm not forgetting. I'm forgetting 1,000 of them. There's a lot of them. I can't name them all, I'm sorry. But is anyone familiar with MAGFest at all? Okay. So our awesome friends at the Baltimore Gamer Symphony Orchestra had this mad idea, this amazing idea, but any idea that is awesome is also completely insane, to combine forces from all of the Gamer Symphony Orchestras. So we're about 55 people, and they had signups for people from any orchestra or if you just wanted to come play. So at MAGFest, Saturday morning, 10 a.m. in this Gaylord atrium, we had over 130 musicians together from all these different orchestras just coming together for our love of video game music. And this ties into this piece because we actually debuted that piece at that performance. So this is Battle at the Summits. It's a very exciting champion battle theme, and it's actually our first time performing a full orchestra Pokémon piece. So, without further ado, let's battle. We took this long to play Pokemon, but whoa, what a piece to start with. Be many more Pokemon games for us in the future. All right, this next piece is actually from one of my personal favorite games. Any fans of Fallout out there? All right. So I have to say, I'm really sorry. I'm kind of one of those like new school Fallout fans who just started with like New Vegas and 3 and Fallout 4 and all of them. And one day I'll play the originals. But this one is from Fallout 4. And I think this is the one that most emotionally impacted me. And I wanted to arrange this piece. In Fallout 4, you start off with this, you're just living your life. It's just you and your partner and your young son, and everything's beautiful, but there's a lot of just tension brewing in the world. And then everything kind of gets turned upside down when this person shows up at your door saying, we're promising you spots in this vault, And, you know, there's gonna be radioactive bombs falling, you have to get in there. And then the sirens sound, and then just, you know, within the blink of an eye, everything just changes. And you go into like a cryogenic stasis for a long time, and you wake up and your entire world is just turned upside down. And this is just kind of coping with like the loss of like that life you once knew. And you know, you're trying to put your family back together, you're trying to find your son. And you're in this strange world teeming with monsters and mutants, and people are frightened. There's people being kidnapped left and right. And Fallout's just a scary place. You know, we play video games often to escape and to live new worlds, but Fallout is probably like the one place I don't think any of us would want to go to. It's a very dark and scary world. But this music is very just monumental and just really reflects you know, everything that your character has gone through and is kind of exploring this strange new world. So here's Fallout 4. I'm going to bring Kyle back up onto the stage to conduct this next piece.
All right. So for this next piece that we're about to play for you today, just a quick story. For those of you who were at our spring concert last year, we played an amazing arrangement from one of two of Final Fantasy's MMORPGs, Republic of Bastok from Final Fantasy XI. We're very happy to be representing Final Fantasy's other MMORPG today. That is Final Fantasy XIV, Final Fantasy XIV Endwalker, to be exact. And this next piece is a combination of clothes in the distance and of countless stars. Now, this plays when you're in a place called the Ultima Thule, where emotions dictate reality, and even more so, you as the player character, the allies that you have in this region, they start to dwindle bit by bit, and then you're basically trying to stand tall alone, which can be very difficult. And one other important reason that we're playing this game, or not playing this game, but the music from this game in particular, I would like you just to think about for a moment, if you've had any sort of significant loss in your life, just think about that by yourself for a moment. The hardest part about that, it's not the fact that that person or that thing may be gone, it's the hole they leave behind. And then the question becomes, not how do we move on, but how do we move forward? How do we stand tall even when it seems so difficult to do so? And this moment in Final Fantasy XIV, you may be asking yourself that, how do we just not move on, but move forward? And even with that, there is still hope, and it is always worth it to move forward. And this arrangement of clothes in the distance and of countless stars, I almost fell there, my word. this arrangement of clothes in the distance and of countless stars, we hope that it gives this kind of hope. Through the darkness that you may be experiencing in the game, effectively. So, without further ado, we do hope that this piece gives you the courage to move forward, no matter how difficult it may be. This is from Final Fantasy XIV Endwalker, Close in the Distance, End of Countless Stars. And with that, I almost forgot. I almost forgot, my word. This is going to feature our choir and a few select soloists here, so let's bring them out. I see they're coming out. And with that, sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Whispers falling silently drift on the wind, but I hear you, our journey, now a memory fading from sight, but I see you, unbroken, promises we made so long ago. You're still here, unspoken, requiem for a river of tears.
Flowing, winding toward eternal sea, and yet
we have
Big round of applause for our soloists. Thank you all very much. And before we get to our last piece of the evening, I believe we have the raffle.
All right, so every concert you come to here, you have a chance to win some great swag, a mug, and we also have our merch table as well, so don't forget to pick up a sticker or a magnet or some other fun stuff. And yeah, don't forget to also follow us on social media. We're on Instagram, YouTube, under New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra, and we also have our website, NJGSO.org, so our New Jersey Gamer Symphony, it's on the program, so. So follow us online and keep posted with our next concert. We're going to be at Digital Press Games on July 23rd, that's Sunday, so we're gonna be doing some small ensemble music there, so be sure to catch us there. And yeah, so, you know, I just wanna take a minute before our final piece of the evening to talk about this amazing group that we have here. So this amazing group of musicians, every Sunday they come together, they work really hard. And yeah, during the week, everyone here is, we're not professional musicians, we're a community orchestra, so you know, everyone here, you know, we have lawyers and engineers and teachers and all sorts of people coming together, but we all come together all the time. Just for our love of video games and our love of music, and you know, that's, we're just crazy about making awesome music together. So now here's to many more seasons with the New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra. Yeah! All right, let me turn to the next page here. There we go. Okay, so we really like Final Fantasy here in this group, as you can hear. We've played music from, let's see, the whole list. Final Fantasy 1, Final Fantasy 4, Final Fantasy 5, Final Fantasy 6, Final Fantasy 7, we do love our one-winged angel, after all. Final Fantasy 11, Final Fantasy 14, as you just heard. Not yet Chocobo Racing, but we'll get there eventually. We did Crystal Chronicles, George, that's right. Knew that was George. We did Crystal Chronicles and many, 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 many more Final Fantasy games. But this is our first time playing music from Final Fantasy VIII. Oh, yeah. Yeah, so we played One Winged Angel a lot from Final Fantasy VII, and I mean a lot. We love that song. But it was time to, I think, kind of bring in a new song kind of in a similar vein. And what makes Final Fantasy VIII's the song just very interesting is that you would expect it to be like a final boss theme or expect it to be at the end of a New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra concert, which it is, but it's actually the start to Final Fantasy VIII. It's this insanely intense cutscene, just showing like, you know, fights and struggles, and it's really something. But yeah, this piece is just really just like portrays like just like the despair of this world and just like the struggles that the characters are going through. And I think I'm gonna let it speak for itself. So here's Liberi Fatali from Final Fantasy VIII.
Thank you.
I'm hearing these shouts from the audience. Encore, one more song. Do we know another song? We have another? Oh, Unwinged Angel. All right. Yeah, let's see. Who wants to hear another song? Yeah! How badly do you want to hear another song? As it turns out, we have another song to play. All right. I don't think this series needs any introduction. It's, I think, the only game in the world where you can battle Mario and Link and Pikachu and Captain Falcon and Bayonetta and Sonic the Hedgehog and Sans Undertale as a Mii fighter, all in one crazy, fantabulous mishmash. It's so over the top. There's just so much there. Everyone is here, like literally, right? Everyone is here. All right. So we actually, a couple years ago when Smash Ultimate debuted, we performed a whole Smash Symphony. We played Melee, N64, Brawl, Smash 4, and Smash Ultimate, which had, that song had literally, the game hadn't even released by the time, or it had just come out when we did the performance. So this is actually the theme for Smash Ultimate. So, choose your fighter! I see we got Wario over here. We got our fighter. All right. It's time for Super Smash Brothers!
Thank you.
We'd like to thank the staff at the Williams Center, JT, and Michael is up there, and everyone else for helping make this performance possible. So thank you, guys. Please come support the Rivoli Theater. There's a lot of film screenings here. There's board game nights. There's our whole calendar online. A lot of fun events that are happening here. So please support them in their effort to restore this amazing theater. And it's been such an honor to be, I think, the first orchestra to play here. Or at least the first orchestra since, you know, who knows when to play here. So yeah. Give it up for the New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra.
We've got one last thank you to give for today. And I just want to say the New Jersey Gamer Symphony Orchestra would absolutely not be possible without this one person. And it is the person right next to me right now. Please give an amazing thank you to Elisa Menes, our director. So much for coming out and supporting us. It means the world to us, and we will see you for our next concert. And we all hope you had a great time and get home safely. And thank you all again.